Good morning students, we are going to start with our first lesson, that is basic concepts in geometry. So now you will be not knowing what is this word geometry called as, because this is totally new word for you. So geometry means the study in mathematics based on lines, shapes, rays, points and curves. So what is that? It is the study based in mathematics which is based on the lines, the shapes, the rays, the points and the curves. Now you will be also thinking, now teacher, what is all these words? So we will see one by one which are the basic concepts in this geometry. So the first concept is the point. Now a point is shown by a tiny dot. You can see over here in this picture given below that we have represented point A, point B and point C. Always remember one thing, capital letters are used to represent a point. You cannot use small initials. For example, you cannot use small a to represent a point. This is totally wrong. You are supposed to use the capital letters to represent the point. Now, the next part of it is the line segment. This is the next basic concept in geometry. So, what is line segment? So, we'll just see now. Line segment is a part of a line. So, what you should understand one thing, line segment is a part of a line. A small piece of that line. Now you will be knowing a big cake. A small piece of it means the pastries which you eat. Same way, if the line is big, a small part of it is called as the line segment. Now you can see over here a line is drawn. Okay, the line name is M and A and B are the two points. So what I can say over here, if M is the line, segment AB is called as line segment. Again I am repeating what I said over here, if this M is line, so segment AB is called as line segment. Now you can see this whole line which is represented, from that AB is part of it. त्या मोठ्या लाईनचा एक छोटा तुकडा, वी कॅन से दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज द सेगमेंट. सो इन दिस डायग्राम segment AB is called as line segment. So there is one note for you. While representing a line segment, use segment in front of it. You are supposed to write segment AB, not only AB, you are supposed to write segment AB. Is that clear? Okay, now we will go for the third part, that is line. Now what we have studied? We have studied about the point, we have studied about the line segment. Now what is line? Line can be extended in both the directions. There is no end points for line. So if you stretch the line at both the directions, you can see it is unending. You can extend it in both the ways. So when you extend a line in both the ways, so you are going to represent a line over here. Here the name of the line is line N. Next you can see over here, I have constructed one line and it is little big than the earlier one. Here the name of the line is line L. So one thing you can observe here, point we were representing in the form of capital letters. Line is supposed to be represented in form of small initials. So there is one note for you. Represent line in small alphabets always. And use words like line L, line N, etc. while writing lines. Don't only write L, N. You are supposed to use the word line L and line N. For segment also, line segment also, you are supposed to use the word segment AB, segment PQ, segment AC. Okay? Now, the fourth part of it is rays. So what are rays? Now we are familiar about the sun rays. We are knowing when we lighten up the torch, the rays come out of that torch. Same way, rays, what are these rays? We will just see. Ray is one part of a line. It starts from one point and go continuously in other direction. If you observe this picture over here, here it is starting at point P and it is getting continuous front, it is going front in the form of PQ. So you are going to read this ray as ray PQ. You are not supposed to read it as QP. See from where it starts. It starts from point P. It starts from this origin P. So you are supposed to read it as PQ, not QP. Okay. Now you are knowing the sun. So the sun rays also are coming in one direction. So yes, that's why we term them as sun rays. Same way in line, you can represent a ray which is part of line itself, and the name of this ray is ray PQ. Is that clear? Okay, so that is one small definition, or you can say as one important note for you. Starting point of ray is called as its origin. So if we observe this picture here, if you observe this figure here, here P is said to be as the origin, from because the ray is starting over here. So here P is called to be as the origin. Now one note also along with this. What is the note given to you? We should always read ray as ray PQ, not as ray QP. Again, I am telling you, because some students are doing mistake in this part. You are supposed to read it as ray PQ, but not as ray QP. Is that clear? Yes. Here, there is one example shown. I have drawn one ray over here. You are supposed to read it as ray NM, not as ray MN. It is wrong. You are supposed to read as ray NM. And N is the origin of this ray. Now, the fifth part of this basic concept in geometry is the plane. Now, normally we are familiar with this word plane. So, what is a plane? If you see in this picture given below, here is one small table drawn. I know it is not that good. Here is one flat surface drawn for you. So, what is plane in geometry? Flat surface is called as a plane. So, wherever you find a flat surface, it is termed as a plane. For example, floor. The floor on which you stand, the floor on which you sit, etc. Bench, where you sit down, books, and etc. So, here is a table drawn for you. This table, the flat surface which you can see, is called as a plane. Now, plane can be extended at the four sides. You can see here. You can extend this plane however you want. Okay. So, whatever the flat surface you will find out, that flat surface is called as a plane. So the next part of this is the parallel lines. So what are parallel lines? We can see now the lines which lie in the same plane but do not intersect each other are called as parallel lines. Now you can see over here these two lines I have constructed in violet color, that are line M and line N. I am not reading it as M, N. I am reading it as line M and line N. You can see over here another pair, that is line P and line Q. If you observe this picture, you can see that they are going straight along with each other. They are not intersecting each other. Te kuthehi ekmekana bhetat nahi. So these lines are said to be as the parallel lines. These lines are separate and these lines are separate. You cannot say that these both are same. I am speaking about parallel lines. And when you are using the term parallel line, you must be requiring two lines so that you can show that they are parallel. One line I cannot say they are parallel. Okay. Again, I have used the word lines over here. Lines which lie in the same plane but do not intersect each other are said to be as parallel lines. So what are the examples? The opposite edges of your notebook. If you observe your notebook, the opposite edges, If this is one part, this one is another part, you can see they both are also parallel. Railway track, if you have observed, if you have traveled anytime, you can see the track on which the railway travel. It is also parallel. Okay. Now the next part of it is the intersecting lines. So what are intersecting lines? The lines which intersect with each other are called as intersecting lines. The line which intersect each other are called as intersecting line. You can see over here, they are intersecting at point O, you can say. They are intersecting over here at point O. So these lines are said to be as intersecting lines. You are supposed to use the word, you are supposed to use a small initials only. Small initials means small alphabets. Here line P and line Q are intersecting. They are touching each other at point O. That's why they are said to be as intersecting lines.